Welcome to episode 4 of the Nintendo Newscast. Introducing your hosts, Lauren and Amiibo Jason.
Good evening, Nintendo fans. How's it going? It's Amiibo Jason here. We're back once again with a fantastic, fun-filled episode of the Nintendo Newscast, previously known as the Amiibo Newscast. How you doing today? Who are you, by the way?
Who am I?
Yeah, introduce yourself.
I guess you're not familiar with
me. I am new to you.
Oh, okay. Well, in that case, I'm Lauren, also known as Happily Candied.
Where did that nickname come from, by the way? Happily Candied.
Happily Candied. Well, it's actually a pretty great story. Actually, it's really not. But it's something that I kind of came up with myself. It goes back to, I think, 2009-ish. I was bouncing around from name to name, alias to alias online.
Of course.
I was very.
Why wouldn't you?
I know. I was very indecisive back then until I finally realized I need to have a consistent name online.
Sure.
And I wanted to be able to capture that with something that I really loved and something that I thought, this is not going to fade over time. Something that I'll always truly be passionate about. And that, for me,
is candy
and sweets.
That makes sense.
Doesn't it make sense?
It makes sense.
Everybody who knows me knows that I love pastries and anything sugar. Come on.
And I just splashed some water like in my face here. I'm good though.
Apparently that's funny.
And
but yeah,
I'm just gonna use this Mew. Oh,
gosh. To wipe it He's rubbing his nose with his Mew plushie.
Get some water on there.
Good, very good. Yeah, so I came across this Japanese type of really cutesy site, and some things on it said Happy Candied. And I'm like,
that. So you just stole the name.
No, I didn't steal the name. I'm like, that doesn't sound right. That doesn't seem grammatically correct. So in my mind for months and months, it stuck with me the term Happily Candied. And I thought, you know, this is obviously really important to me.
Apparently.
It stuck with me, and I thought, I'm going to use that. And sure enough, the .com was available, email was available.
So it was a win-win.
It was a win-win, and I have become...
Well, it's a win for you. I don't know who it was a win for anybody else. So it was just a win.
Yes, and I have become defined by it now. And, you know, I could have changed it when I jumped on board with Nintendo Inquirer and Amiibo News, but I decided to keep it.
And we are very happy you did.
It's who I am. I don't want to lose that sense of individuality.
Ask me how I got my name.
I know how you got your name, but I'm going to ask you anyway because it's a fun story.
All right, yeah, ask
Amiibo
me.
Jason, how did you get your name?
I like Amiibo and my name is Jason.
That's really creative.
That's how I got it. So I'm like, hey, oh my God, I could put the two together.
Yeah.
And then I did it. And then here I am.
If only you had given me the ability and the option to name you.
Yeah, I'm very happy I didn't. Well,
you could have been something a lot more interesting.
No, Amiibo Jason is where it's at. So.
Okay, on that note.
We're going to kick this awesome Nintendo Newscast off with episode 4. We've been doing this for quite some time now, if you've been following with us since the Amiibo Newscast. We're going to have a lot of fun tonight. There's been a lot of news, and it's not just, like, happy news. Happily candy.
Happily candy.
Some
news.
Of it is sad candy. Some of it's sad news. It depends on, I guess, how you look at it. If you're just, like, an excessive optimist, maybe you'll say, this is great news. But if you're like everybody else, you'll probably be borderline bummed, but we'll get there.
Yes.
But we're going to start off with some fun stuff before we kick off into the news. So first of all, I just want to point out, I picked up a bunch of crap.
Don't call it crap. It's cool stuff.
I picked up a bunch of really cool stuff.
That's so much
better. I call it crap because I don't have room for it right now. but yeah, I picked up every Kirby Amiibo, and you probably saw this. Mm-hmm. If you're watching this, you've probably seen our unboxing videos. We got every single Kirby Amiibo from Japan in, which was very cool. And we did a diorama unboxing, too.
We did.
Which I'm putting over the screen right now. Like, magic. Isn't it amazing? The magic of editing.
You're so good at that. Happen. You're so good at that.
Thank you.
Yeah.
I do my best. Yeah. So we have that. I also got this amazing Majora's Mask Link Nendroid. I haven't opened it yet. I'm waiting to do a video. I haven't had time to do videos because I've been doing videos on lots of other stuff.
What a conundrum.
I know, it's crazy. If only I had more time.
If only.
If only there was more Amiibo Jasons to go around.
Oh, that's what the world is really hoping for.
That's what we need. We can only duplicate myself. Yeah. And I just wanted to show this off real quick. If you're watching at home, you'll see what it is. But if you're listening, this is the Popstar Kirby set that came out in Japan. It came with an Amiibo diorama and a Kirby Amiibo. I just like it because it's a really interesting box.
It's the first time we've seen something like this.
Check that out.
And I think you said it's up for a very fair price too, which I think makes it even a little bit more interesting because it's very good quality.
You can get it at AmiAmi, you can get it at Play Asia, any import site you want to go to, I'm sure you can find it.
Yeah.
So those were my pickups that I had. You got a pickup too.
Yeah, probably want to stop shaking the table.
No, I like shaking.
No, please don't. Earthquake.
Nah. You got a pickup too.
I did. What did you get? A pickup. You know, I rarely order anything for myself these days, but this one I could not help. So first I'm going to lead into this by saying we posted this really great article. In fact, I wrote it a couple of weeks ago.
It was so good because you wrote it.
No, I wasn't saying it was good because I wrote it. I was saying it was good because the content itself was worth writing about.
That's what you meant.
Like, one of my favorite things to write about is Nintendo merchandise. I love products. And we found this Etsy product on Reddit posted by a user. And it was a Poochie custom, I believe it's pronounced amigurumi, type of like knit crochet plush. A lot of time goes into these things. So I'm going to show this now. And it is a Poochie amigurumi plush. Extremely well done. It is the perfect complementary size to the Yarn Yoshi, the mini Yarn Yoshi amiibo.
I can't wait till you actually do your photo shoot.
Yes, I have a big photo shoot planned. I need a couple more props to put together for the big photo shoot. It's going to be very colorful and complimentary to Yoshi's Woolly World.
We could actually have him hang out here for most of the newscast.
Let's see if we can do this. But yeah, I better point out first that I did make some modifications to this custom.
It's never good enough.
I'm sorry. Whenever I get something even that's handmade, I always have to make modifications to it to make it my own and one of a kind. So I replaced the orange pom-pom on the tail with a yellow one. I felt it was a little bit more accurate to the game, even though the one in the game is a yellowish orange, but I like the yellow more. And the collar around it had originally been made of felt, and I was like, no, you know, I think I need something that represents Poochie a little bit more. So I actually found leather, like fake leather, and I cut the band, and then I put actually gold studs on it, and I painted them gold because I couldn't find real gold studs, and I'm very happy with the results.
It turned out pretty good.
It did turn out very well. I'm very pleased with it, and I can't wait to get this guy with all the Yarn Yoshis outside, and I'm going to have a lot of fun, and I'm going to be able to share those with people and make some wallpapers for some people, too.
There you go.
Yeah.
That ends another episode of Crafting with Lauren.
Sorry, I haven't been able to get the customizer out in me lately.
Yeah,
everything,
it's good.
Everything,
you do good stuff.
Yes. I've been customizing all different toys for many years, but I have not yet done Amiibo.
So. I'm hoping that Nintendo Japan releases a Yarn Yoshi diorama. That would be very cool.
That's on the top of my top three wish lists for the dioramas.
Cross
right
your
now.
Fingers. Yeah. Nintendo has nothing else going on this year, so why not?
Whoa.
Push those dioramas out.
I think we're going to get into that a little bit more
later. We'll get there. We have a fun-filled episode of Amiibo news and Nintendo news to cover. But first, we're going to talk about Pokemon Sun and Moon.
Yes.
So you might have known a while back we had a sort of reveal trailer, kind of. Mm-hmm. It gave us like zero look at Pokemon Sun and Moon.
Zero look.
Like, it gave us nothing besides, like, I think we got to see like a wireframe of this supposedly new Pokemon.
Yeah.
And we got the we didn't get the cover art, we got the logos.
Yeah.
But the logos got leaked
before
like anything anyway, so it's not like that really even mattered. But we know Sun and Moon is coming this year. And we also know now at this point, on May 10th, we're going to have brand new Pokemon Sun and Moon information. Me being a lifelong Pokemon fan, I'm ecstatic. I can't wait, even though I can't even tell you what half the Pokemon are at this point. But
it's too many. Too many released up to this point.
Oh, for sure. Yeah. And honestly, I've been looking forward to this since I finished Pokemon X and Y.
Yeah.
So obviously I played the remakes Omega Ruby and Alpha Sapphire as well.
Yeah.
But this is going to be our first real, like, big Pokemon Adventure since X and Y. Yeah. So I'm getting psyched, but I wanted to get your opinion on this. So sure. We have had like this lull of information on Pokemon Sun and Moon since it got leaked, and then the next day that it got announced. So I was curious to see what your thoughts are on like this whole waiting game that Nintendo seems to like to put us through.
Oh, yeah. Nintendo loves to make us wait.
It's Game Freak, too. I guess I can't put all the blame necessarily on Nintendo.
But no.
It's easier that way.
Yeah.
Much easier.
I don't mind waiting. I think that having to wait for every single type of major release, NX, Zelda, and everything else that has been basically big in Nintendo news lately, I think it's pushing it a little much and pushing the patience of fans.
Yeah.
Because everything is basically lumped together right now, being pushed towards the end of the year or even into next year. Mm-hmm. And for me, I think in a smart business sense, you would want to have a constant stream of releases. So people are constantly being entertained and they don't have to wait on the edge of their seats for this huge lump of releases all at once. To me, it just makes sense that way. I'd love to be able to sit down with somebody who really knows their stuff business-wise, or even someone from Nintendo would be amazing, and have them explain this to me. Why?
Because they don't have any games. I mean, it's you can't force them to manufacture or produce more games.
Absolutely. I think it's not that.
I think we're moving more into what we're going to get into anyway.
Oh, no. I'm not even talking about they should have these releases all right now or even right now. I'm talking about the news itself. Why not pace people a little bit better and get people even more hyped by releasing chunks of news, official news, not news that's getting leaked through other sources right now.
I mean,
because a lot of times the leaks happen right before Nintendo plans to get the news out itself. So that's how I feel.
I think people are just hunting for things. I mean, Nintendo needs to patent stuff and they need to make sure they get copyrights out for stuff too. So we have like websites like NerdLeaks where like searching through these things. So obviously some stuff is going to get found out.
Yes.
With Pokemon, I mean, we have a long way to wait. We know it's coming out winter 2016, hopefully. I don't think it's going to be pushed back. I don't think they dare to push it past a Christmas release this year.
Yeah.
But I'm hoping that we're going to see something substantial. The only real hint that we have besides like the 30 seconds of like sort of footage that we got from the last reveal trailer, if you want to call it that, we have like a little crystal that's in the Japanese logo that some people are saying is going to be a way that like humans and Pokemon could somehow merge together. I have no idea.
That's a leap.
It is a leap.
That's a leap.
It is, but Mega Evolution was a leap. Yeah. And I had, when I heard that there was going to be Mega Evolution, I couldn't believe it.
Yeah.
I'm like, that is crazy that you get a stone and you can make something evolve even more than it has already. Yeah. So I guess it wouldn't be completely out of the realm of possibility. I think Pokemon is finally moving in this direction where they need to come up with new mechanics so it stays fresh.
Yep.
Mega Evolution was how they did it with X and Y, and I think this could be something we could see happen.
Definitely, and I think it's great that we see the new mechanics introduced like that. For me, Nintendo has never gone to the extreme in a bad way when it comes to Pokemon.
Yeah.
And I loved what I saw in X and Y. That was one of my favorite Pokemon games ever. I'm definitely not as big of a Pokemon player as you are. I haven't gone that far back in my past.
You don't own a Pokemon Snap Station?
I unfortunately do. Very few Pokemon longtime fans do. So, I mean, that is something very special.
So diehard.
But yeah, I loved X and Y, and I'm looking forward to what Sun and Moon have to bring.
So we shouldn't have too long to wait. It's going to be happening on Tuesday, May 10th. We will be covering it pretty much the second it comes out. Hopefully we get more than 5 seconds of footage. I would like to see what legendaries we're going to have in this game, what the box arts are going to be. Mm-hmm. We also know that Korokoro, Japanese pop culture, mostly gaming magazine, they have a reveal coming at some point this month as well, supposedly showing off the cover. So
yes,
we should get our first glimpse at whatever legendaries we're going to have in store.
I do. I'm not a fan of the rumors as much as I once was, but I do love the little sneak peeks that Korokoro gives us.
Oh, yeah.
They're just enough to kind of like keep us wondering what's next.
Well, I think one of the reasons why Nintendo's posting this event, I'm thinking that's actually going to be happening before the Korokoro, is magazine stuff gets leaked way far in advance. Yeah. So having a magazine, like especially a Japanese magazine, when Pokemon is universal, I mean, Pokemon is something that everybody gets excited about. So having it like one region, like getting access to that reveal, I think is completely unfair. And not to mention, people get the magazines early. People who work in manufacturing or distribution, they snap photos of it, they make their way online, and then the reveal's ruined. So I like what Nintendo does with their direct approach. So hopefully we'll be getting some announcement for a Pokemon Direct happening in the next few days.
That's what I'm hoping. I really am.
Because obviously we know on Tuesday it's coming in Japan, at least this trailer. So I'm guessing either tomorrow, I would say Monday at the latest, they're going to be announcing something for the the US and
the UK.
So cross your fingers. All right. That's what we know so far in Pokemon Sun and Moon. Get excited. It's finally going to be finally getting some information on it. So what's your favorite Pokemon, by the way?
Favorite Pokemon? Oh, I have... Oh, I'm trying to think about my very favorite. Sylveon has to be my favorite right now.
You do have a lot of cards.
I do have a lot of Sylveon cards. I think I have most of them now. I actually do like a lot of different Pokemon, but I really like the Sylveon one. I feel like it's kind of like that typical girly pink, you know, very fairy type. It is a fairy type, and that's why I was always hesitant to tell people that my favorite is Sylveon.
No, I love Sylveon.
I can't deny it. I love Sylveon. It's just so adorable, and I feel like if I were in Pokemon form, it would be Sylveon.
The very first thing I did when I got an EV in X and Y was evolve it into a Sylveon.
Did you? Okay.
And it's not difficult. I don't feel as
I don't have to second guess myself as much anymore.
Not at all.
We can embrace the Sylveon love.
Absolutely. So yeah, if I think if you remember, I don't even know if you did. You play X and Y?
Yes. To get Sylveon? I actually didn't. I don't even think I got Sylveon.
Really? It's so easy.
It probably is. You just fed it
lots of pastries. Like you fed your Eevee lots of pastries.
So basically it is like it's a Pokemon version of me.
Yeah, if you could evolve into anything, it would be a Sylveon.
It would be a Sylveon. Oh, that's good to know. Of the world, I am a Sylveon in Pokemon.
Easy peasy.
Yeah.
I'd be a Raichu. I'm cute like Pikachu, but I'm far superior in every way.
Is Raichu also cuter in person?
He is.
He is. Guaranteed.
Raichu's my boy.
Verified.
You know it. All right, next I want to move on to the Amiibo news portion of the Nintendo Newscast.
Ooh.
It's exciting because it's kind of like the Amiibo Newscast is coming
back. Yeah, it's coming back. It's temporary, but it's not the end of it because I know that we're going to be doing these occasionally from now on.
You know what? Just for old time's sake, Jared Rutledge, hit the intro.
Welcome to episode 25 of the Amiibo Newscast. Introducing your hosts, Lauren and Amiibo Jason.
Oh man, that felt good. All right. It's kind of weird. I know Lauren's like, what the hell are you doing? But I'm going to edit the intro in there.
No, I believe you.
I know, I will.
Trust me, you didn't even have to tell me that and I knew it.
Good.
Yeah. All right. I know you.
Welcome back to the Amiibo Newscast, folks.
Yes.
Episode 26. I think we left off at 25.
Yeah,
right?
I think you're right.
All right, this is fun. I've been looking forward to talking about this for a while. We were just on the Toys for Games cast.
We were, by the way. And I had a blast. Oh, I love Josh and Greer.
I do too.
I really do.
But they stole our thunder because they pretty much talked about what I wanted to talk about. And they stole the title for this episode because I was going to call this episode Stay Fresh. And I'm still going to call it Stay Fresh.
Did they?
Screw you, Toys for Games cast. I'm using it anyway.
Did you mention that to Josh and Greer?
No, I didn't mention it.
Oh, that's so strange.
It doesn't matter.
Great minds. Great minds.
But this episode is called Stay Fresh, too, so deal with it. Deal with it. What are you going to do?
They're going to
sue me.
They're going to just pester you so much and say, you copied us.
I use the same thumbnail, too. I don't give a damn.
Do we have to edit that?
No.
Okay, I don't know what's considered safe.
Oh, damn, is family friendly.
Is it?
Yeah.
Nowadays, I guess it
is. It's like a beaver.
When we were young, that would have not been acceptable.
Yeah. Don't let your parents hear this episode, kids.
Kitties.
Yeah. All right, let's get into it. So we found out that we're getting a bunch of new Splatoon Amiibo.
Yeah.
Let's get in the Amiibo News time machine here real quick and go back about a month. about a month ago, it might even be a little bit longer, yeah. Somebody scoured through some update code from a Splatoon update that hit the Wii U. And I wish I could remember this guy's name. If for some reason I find it during editing, I'll put it there in the bottom of the screen. But he found code for essentially Squid Sisters Amiibo.
Yep.
And nobody really believed it. They're like, it's never going to happen. And the folks that did want it to happen, they were super excited. So am I. I think they're very, very interesting characters. Some people find them annoying. I find them borderline endearing. I think the Japanese culture and the Squid Sisters, they mesh very well together with the concerts they throw. Yeah. And they scream. They just absolutely scream like Japanese glamour culture. And that's why I think these two particular characters are so popular in Japan.
I think, yeah, I was going to say they're definitely popular in Japan. When we were talking on the Toys for Life game... Oh, sorry.
Toys for Gamescast.
It
was
sorry.
Her that didn't remember.
Sorry, Josh.
Me.
Sorry, Greer. My mind is everywhere right now. I know I mentioned that the Squid Sisters were not well received, and I really actually meant that in the U.S. and in the West. I didn't mean for Japan. I know that they're actually very popular in Japan because the whole style, everything they represent is very Japan. I did like them when they came out. I do wish they served more of a, had more function, I guess, within the game.
Well, I don't want to spoil anything.
I do understand that they're considered more of the entertainment part of the game. So I get that.
I don't want to spoil anything because I know you didn't finish Splatoon.
No, I didn't.
But if you finished Splatoon, they actually had a really big role in the game.
Did they really?
They did.
Okay, that's good.
I'm not going to ruin it.
But I was going to say, I'm sure other people have not finished it either.
By this point, I'm sure you finished the game, but I'm not going to get too far into that piece of it. But we do have a Squid Sisters 2-pack coming out later this year. And I'm excited for that for a few reasons. Number one, I like the idea of this being our very first 2-pack.
Yes.
And I like the idea they decided not to bundle a little squid in there and tried to get 10 extra bucks out of me. Good job, Nintendo.
Yeah.
But they did bundle a squid with the next box set. It's kind of bizarre, though. No, I guess maybe it's not. We're the only region where you can't buy these Sons of Guns separately. You have to buy them in the 2-pack.
Maybe it's because they know that the Squid Sisters, like they said, were not as well received here as they were in Japan.
Yeah.
And they figured that they won't sell as much if they're sold individually.
Yeah.
I think marketing-wise, it is a smart move. Other amiibo, like Animal Crossing, were sold that way too. So I think it makes sense to do this.
Yeah, and I think this holiday season, when the moms are in like the amiibo aisle, they don't have to pick between what weird squid girl did my kid want, the pink one or the green one.
Yeah.
So now you gotta buy this one. So yeah, we get the Squid Sister 2-pack, $24.99, coming to stores on July 8th in the US, July 7th in Japan. Darn you guys, you got it one day early.
Oh, it's not fair. Hey, and it's within the same range. I'm pretty satisfied.
I'll forgive him this time. Thank goodness.
I know. I was worried.
So that's the 2-pack. We have another 3-pack coming out. This is the more controversial subject on the Amiibo newscast. We have more or less repaints of Inkling Boy, Inkling Girl, and the Squid. They also have different weapons, but more or less the weapons are the same. So let's not kid ourselves.
Agreed.
So we have I swear to God, it's hard to tell when you put these things side by side, but we have a lighter skinned Inkling Girl. She's got green hair, green ink, green gun. We have a darker skinned Inkling Boy, purple hair, purple gun, purple ink. And we got ourselves an orange little Squiddy.
Yeah, Squiddy.
Super cute. Love that Squiddy.
Yes.
And again, you can only buy that in the 3-pack if you want the Squid in the U.S. Otherwise, you can buy the Boy and the Girl separately for $12.99 or two easy payments of about, $6.50.
Yes.
Yeah. I don't think any place has payment plans.
Yeah, I don't think anyone needs payment plans for that.
But again, the U.S., for some reason, we don't get access to the Squid Amiibo on its own. If you want that, you have to import it. But I guess that's not a huge deal.
No, I don't really think it is.
Lauren.
Yes.
Thoughts on the 3-pack?
I don't have major problems with the 3-pack itself. I know that you're not a fan of, if you want the Squid, you have to get the 3-pack. I don't mind that. I get it. My main issue is with the designs.
Yep.
I think they could have been a lot more creative. I would have loved to have seen a roller instead, because I love the roller as a weapon in Splatoon. So, and it's so much more different than what we've seen in the previous Splatoon amiibo.
Yeah.
I think it could have stood out a lot more, too, and offered a little bit more variety with color and shape. So I would have liked to see that instead. I'm pretty sure that we'll see customs with rollers, though, eventually.
Oh, yeah. I think we have some already.
If we already have some? Okay. So,
put them on the screen.
Ooh, right Magic. Yeah, but jumping away from the three-pack, I also wanted to comment that I love the aesthetic design of the Squid Sisters.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, the paint splashing on the bottom.
It's very cute.
They won me over with the paint splashing on the bottom alone. I already have this image in mind for a custom I would like of one of them. So do you want to share it with the folks at home? I'm not going to share it right now. I might have to approach one of my favorite customizers about it. So
on the next episode of Crafting with Laura, we find out what she's going to do to the Squid Sister Amiibo.
No.
Tune in, NPR, 10 o'clock.
Stop it.
Right before Horse Talk.
Stop it.
So... I'm surprised you haven't mentioned this.
I'm like heating up now for some reason.
What?
I don't know.
I'm surprised you haven't mentioned the sparkle dresses on these.
I like the sparkle dresses. Well,
they're so cute. It's like this cute sparkle paint. I like that.
I'm sorry. Are you going to give me more problems with Crafting with Lauren?
On episode 3 of Crafting with Lauren, we talk sparkle paints.
Sparkle paints.
Pink and green.
I could spend a whole episode talking about sparkle paints, okay?
If anybody here is very good with Photoshop, could you Photoshop a Crafting with Lauren logo?
No. Really, it's all...
Send it over to Amiibo Jason. The first person to make one, I'll send you, like, a bunch of Pokemon codes.
You are terrible.
I am not.
We're done with this. We're done with this segment.
Oh, we're not done yet. Oh, we're not done. I need to give my two cents on this.
Yes, please do. I know, because you have problems with it.
Yeah, I do.
Oh, what a big surprise.
Yeah. Here's my concern.
Yes. Concern? Oh, Jason concern.
Please Concerns go. With Jason. Mm. Right after Crafting with Lauren.
Whole new spin-offs.
Oh man, yeah, I've got some beef here. I got some beef. We have three characters that have been out for almost a year at this point, and they repainted them, and that's it. And they're expecting me to shell out $34.99. And let's talk about how low I've seen the three pack.
Yeah,
I've seen this Splatoon three pack go down to $16 on Amazon. I've seen individual Inkling Boy and Inkling Girl for $5 on Amazon. Currently, I think Boy is like $5.19 on Amazon. So here they are. They're repainting these things. They're throwing like a little logo on the gun saying, hey, it's Octatech now, so it's new guns.
Yeah.
And they're throwing it in like another three pack for $34.99.
Yeah.
Again, I don't say this often, folks, but I totally agree with Happily Candied. I totally 100% agree. We have so many weapons, so many cool weapons, so many cool characters, so many secondary characters that live in Inkopolis. Why aren't we using that? And where the flip is the Judd Amiibo?
I was hoping you were going to say fudge.
Where's Judd? As Jason Greer would say, what the fudge?
What the fudge?
What the French toast? We got no Judd Amiibo, is not fair at all.
I have to say, I think one of the first comments you made when you saw all of these Amiibo announced was, where is Judd?
Where's Judd?
Yeah. And in fact, that's exactly what I believe Josh said too.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Josh Brown, you're my spirit animal, my friend.
So is Judd.
Judd's pretty good.
Yeah, okay.
I would like to see a Mega Yarn Judd.
I would like to cuddle with him. Oh. Well, yeah, I would like to see... I'd like to see a couple Yarn... variants of all the Splatoon Amiibo. Not the boy and the girl, but like the squid and a bunch of the characters.
Yeah. Well, there is some squid plushies coming out from Jack's Pacific.
Yes.
So one of our friends that went to WonderCon, he took some really cool photos of it.
Cool.
So we put that up on our other little site called Toys Inquirer.
Yes. So, that's right. I remember
shameless
that.
Plug.
Shameless
there it
plug.
Is. So there you go, folks. July 8th, Squid Sisters.
Yep.
And then the shameless three-pack repaint in stores on July 8th, July 7th in Japan. Let us know what you think about this, honestly. I'm really curious to know your thoughts on these three Amiibo. The three-pack and the two-pack. So let us know.
Share your thoughts, please.
Tweet at me, at Amiibo Jason.
At Amiibo Jason. Or Amiibo News.
So now we get to move out of the Amiibo Newscast, and we get to go into the ShoeCast.
ShoeCast.
The ShoeCast.
That's a new thing, too. Another spinoff.
Welcome to the ShoeCast, folks.
We need a new theme song.
We do. Because we don't have enough games to talk about. We're going to be talking about Amiibos and shoes today. So that's what we're going to do. Happily Candied?
Yeah.
Do you want to talk about Vans?
I do not own a lot of Vans. I know you have a fairly large Vans collection.
I have a fairly large Converse All-Star Chuck Taylor's collection.
That's what it is. But you talk about Vans.
I do.
Quite a bit.
Because of the damn Daniel...
That is the third time this week that you have mentioned that.
Hey, you know what? I forgot about Damn Daniel, And then the second we posted about these Nintendo bands coming out, that was every comment that we got. In fact, let's see.
And then you had to mess with poor Daniel on our team.
We do have a Daniel on our team.
Yes, and he likes to be called Daniel.
And he actually really wants these shoes, too.
Jason,
so what am
Jason
I to do?
Took advantage of that situation.
What am I supposed to do? Tell me what I should have done, Lauren. His name is Daniel, and he wanted the shoes.
Stop it.
I had no choice. It was the respectable thing to do.
Can I give my opinion on these shoes?
You can give your opinion on these shoes. Actually, before you give your opinion on the shoes, can you tell the good folks at home that might not know about these shoes?
Yes.
What are we doing here with these shoes?
What do you mean, what are we doing here with these
shoes? What are these shoes?
These shoes are pieces of art that are that display Nintendo all over them. They're fantastic. Yeah. They range from Mario to Donkey Kong to Zelda to Princess Peach to retro NES controllers. We even have, this is pretty great. This is a really creative one. I don't think I would be into this myself, but I love the design and I have to talk about it. The camouflage one, the duck hunt. That is super clever.
Heck to the yeah.
So even if you don't want this shoe that is completely like Nintendo and in your face, you have this very subtle design that's camouflage that will really mesh well with probably a lot of clothes, especially for guys.
Yeah.
And then you have duck hunt, like little, just very tiny images on it. So it's still present, but it's not prominent. And I think that is pretty fantastic.
And it's pretty.
It is very, they're all pretty. And I have to say, I wear dresses a lot, and a lot of my clothes probably wouldn't match the shoes a lot, but I still want both Princess Peaches, and I want to display them as like art pieces instead.
I have worn Chuck Taylors in a suit. Many a time.
Yes, but I feel like you and your style, you can pull that off.
You could too.
I don't think I can handle it. I don't think I can pull that off.
All right, folks. So we have, I'm going to give you a little history behind what happened here with Vans. So let's go back in the Wayback Machine to about 3 days ago. I know for a lot of you, that's very hard to imagine. But 3 days ago, approximately, might be four now. I don't know. It depends on when you listen to this. there was this German website that sells shoes. I didn't know that they made those, but they do. It was a German site. They sold shoes. And they had posted all of these amazing-looking Nintendo Vans. And Vans didn't even have an opportunity to post it themselves. Mm. So here we go. They throw these things up. They throw, I think it was €64.99 for like each pair of these shoes. But then like the next day they took them down, but not before we took the photos down. We got all of them. So we got high tops, we got low tops, we got flip flops, we got baby shoes, we got little kid shoes, we got moccasins. If there's a shoe style for you, if you put things on your feet to walk around, I'm sure you can find something in this collection that's going to appeal to you.
High heels?
No, there's no high heels.
Sorry, I don't even like high heels, but I think it's hilarious that I had to mention the one that
on the next
not
episode of Crafting with Lauren, we attach a heel to a Vans shoe.
Stop it.
There's a few in here I want. Number one, the high top with Mario's face and the Super Mario characters on the front.
You said that's the number one shoe that you want here.
100%.
Yes.
I want it more than anything.
Okay.
It's freaking adorable. I have to point this out.
Yes.
I have the entire DC collection of Converse All-Stars, and I spent way too much money on them. There was a point in my life where every single day of the week I had a different pair of Converse on. And all I could think about was, oh my God, if they made a Nintendo line.
Yeah.
And here we are. We finally have it. So I want to get the high tops. The high tops I want with the design I want happen to be the shoe style that I'm most accustomed to. And that's
Top. No wonder. And I have to say that this design with the Mario and all the Mario characters on there, I feel it's the all-encompassing Nintendo shoe.
Yeah.
And I think that's probably one of the other reasons why you like it so much.
I hope so. And honestly, these are only, so what do we have? We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 pairs of shoes that got leaked from this site. We don't even know if this is the entire collection.
Yeah.
But as of yesterday, Vans actually updated their website. It's like vans.com/Nintendo. They haven't put any photos of the shoes up yet, but they have a teaser page for it up.
Yeah.
They have like a warp pipe with a shoe that like pops out of it. So we know it's officially coming, and the good news is we know it's going to venture out of Europe and it's coming to the US.
Yes.
So prepare your wallets, folks. I am terrified of these.
Worth it. Totally worth it.
There is a Zelda one too.
There is. I'm surprised you didn't mention that one.
It's my least favorite design.
This is not your style, I have to say. The pixel characters on it are very nice looking, but It has this Western look to it almost.
I thought with it had a Native American look to it.
It does. Well, I said Western because I feel like Western is... It covers more bases when it comes to the coloring and, like, the little
yeah.
like, designs on there. But I see the Zelda in it.
And I don't like moccasins. I've never been a moccasin man.
You're not.
I've tried it. I've dabbled.
You're not. I'm sorry. This is not your style.
I had a phase where I wore moccasins, but you know, it was just a phase. But,
just a phase. Can you guess which ones that I can actually see myself wearing?
Can you guess? Is it not Princess Peach?
It is not Princess Peach.
Okay, let me guess. I'm going to say the ones that you can see wearing would be the Yoshi ones or the flip-flops.
False. I hate flip-flops. I hate the sound they make, and I'm just not a fan of flip-flops
all right,
at
which
all.
Ones?
The classic NES controller.
These?
Those, yes.
You know, so... If you're watching this, we'll have this up on the
it's
screen.
It's beautiful, and
they are pretty.
Yes, and
I don't want to say pretty. They're rugged and manly.
They're awesome. I think they would just mesh well with a lot of different types of styles and wardrobes.
Yeah.
So I think that's why I like it. Also, has a very basic type of color scheme, and that would mesh well with a lot of. I have a lot of black dresses and black outfits, and this would work well with it.
I'm honestly probably going to stick to one pair.
Yeah,
and I'm probably going to end up getting the pair that I mentioned. However, I'm thinking there's going to be more than just those 11 pairs.
Yeah.
There are currently like over 40 pairs of DC that we've seen put out by Converse.
Yeah.
So I'd be really, really curious to see what they're going to do with this line.
Yeah.
And if they had a high top Zelda,
yeah,
I would throw my money at the screen right now.
You do never know. We could see another Zelda one. I can't imagine it being limited to just that one design, which isn't even really that great, to be
hopefully
honest.
Hopefully not. So,
yeah.
Cool. Well, those are the shoes. Mm-hmm. Expect them out sometime. We have no idea when. I'm hoping it's going to be by summer.
Yes.
Because I need some new shoes.
Ooh.
I really do. I need a practical shoe.
Buying shoes with Jason.
Yeah. Right after crafting with Lauren. Wait, no.
There was another one.
Yeah, there was another one. I think it was Concerns with Jason.
Yes,
yeah,
so after Concerns with Jason.
Yeah.
We're just what a lineup. What a lineup.
Filling up the airwaves. So expect those out at some point this year. We'll let you know on NintendoEnquire.com when we have any information when pre-orders go up.
As soon as we know, you'll know.
As soon as I get my pair pre-ordered, I'll let you know when you can get yours pre-ordered.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
Wing! All right. I want to talk about a few things because we haven't had the opportunity really to discuss it that in depth yet.
Yes.
So let's move on from the happy, fluffy topics like shoes. And let's move on to some information that we got about Nintendo's E3 plans.
Okay.
Let's go back to last week's podcast. So last week during the podcast, if you saw it, we broke it up into smaller segments for video on the website.
Yep.
On YouTube. We had the full audio episode up on iTunes and Google Play. But we talked a lot about the NX being delayed, which was a bummer and a half. And then we also talked about The Legend of Zelda getting pushed back to 2017. And I need to go back and restate something because you guys are going to crucify me because the NX didn't get delayed. They never announced a date for it to begin with. But the NX is coming out later than many people expected. So I'm very sorry.
You are forgiven by me.
By you.
But not the community.
No, the internet's going to just hang me.
Yes.
So... but now that we know that Nintendo is essentially planning to only cover Zelda U at E3. And when we first heard about this during the investor meeting, I think that was about a week and a half ago now.
Yeah.
The assumption was that their primary focus was going to be on Zelda U, but they obviously, because why wouldn't they? They would still show off like the new Paper Mario, and they would still show off Pokemon Sun and Moon, and they would still show off all these mobile titles that were going to be announced, that were already announced, like Animal Crossing and Fire Emblem. You know, Nintendo doesn't have a lot coming out this year, but it does have some things. Yeah. And Pokemon's not a little franchise. But no, we found out that the entire show floor in the Nintendo side is going to be dedicated to this immersive Zelda U event. And we were talking about this, that we totally see them just like planting grass there, like this Hyrule Field thing.
You're going to give us immersive. You better go all the way about for this.
Oh my God, is that a horse?
Is that a horse?
You got a horse?
Yeah, there better be a whole corral. I want to see a fake sun in the air and a sunset. I want wind blowing.
Yeah.
I mean, this is immersive. Come on, Nintendo, bring it on.
Immerse me.
Immerse us all.
I spent a lot of money on my plane tickets to LA. You better immerse me since that's all I get.
I'm crying on the inside here. I'm still excited about E3.
So am I'm
little,
ecstatic.
I'm a little less excited about the lack of variety that we're going to be seeing, though. I'll admit that.
So we have other game companies that we can look at, too. And then, obviously, third parties are going to be there.
Yeah.
Nintendo has the greatest third-party support. But, you know, there might be something that we can, you know, take a gander at. But here we are. We know that on June 14th that we are going to have a Treehouse event.
Yes.
And Treehouse events are generally pretty fun. It starts at 9 a.m. And from what I understand at this point, and it's pretty conclusive.
Yes.
That this Treehouse event will be in place of a digital event.
That breaks my heart.
Yeah.
That really breaks my heart. Okay. I do enjoy Treehouse events. I was ecstatic last year when we were at E3.
Yeah.
And we got to sit down and watch a Treehouse event live. That was really cool.
Yeah, it was very neat.
Yes. But Treehouse events to me are, even though they're a little bit more conversational.
Yeah.
With the, almost like they're having fun with the audience in a way. I don't find it as informative.
Mm-hmm.
And as official from Nintendo. So, yes, Nintendo, you broke my heart a little bit.
So, they did announce, though, that Reggie's going to be at the Treehouse event.
Yeah, that is cool.
And if this is really going to be the first look, and I'm assuming at this point, and, you know, I'm sorry for assuming, but it has to be. I'm guessing they're going to have the title of the game.
Yes.
The game was supposed to be out, by the way. The game was supposed to be out, by the way, in 2015.
Yeah.
It was supposed to be out in 2015. It was actually supposed to be out even earlier than that.
You know...
And it got delayed and delayed and delayed. It was so... Just the idea that it should already be in our hands and probably be already in a bargain bin somewhere. Yeah. Not a bargain bin. It should have been at least discounted at this point.
Hurtful.
How do we still not know the name of this game?
I don't know. See, that's what I was talking about earlier in this newscast.
Yeah.
Though. I was saying that, no, we don't need the games to be released now. We don't need the games to be released even like within the next couple months. We do, however, need more information on these games to keep people hooked and interested.
I agree.
And a name, you know, that's a great place to start. Same goes for the NX.
What's in a name?
Everything is in a name. Everything is in a name.
By calling a rose by any other name, would it smell as sweet?
Poetry with Shakespeare.
Shakespeare. Prose. I got prose in different area codes.
You're done for the night.
So
you're done for the night.
You guys know me. I'm the Zelda fanatic. I got the tattoos to prove it.
Really?
You know, I always say that, but, you know, it's just more about, it's not just tattoos, man. But I love Zelda.
Man.
And I'm thinking this Treehouse event, I'm thinking the first like 30 minutes are going to be more like a Nintendo Direct.
I hope so. I would like to see it, I guess, turned around a little bit into something more official.
Yeah. Mm-mm. Cross my fingers.
Yeah.
But at the same time, too, here's Jason's thoughts on this.
Oh, good.
We don't have the NX coming until March. Yeah. And for some reason, Nintendo decided it's not ready for them to show at E3. So not having a dedicated digital event makes sense to me, only because it would disappoint so many people. If they tried to, like, load a digital event with the small lineup that they have left coming out this year, mm-hmm. I completely get that.
Yeah.
However, I'm still crossing my fingers that we do see some surprises from Nintendo this year at E3. I'd like some surprise games. I would like to see the rumored possible Animal Crossing mm-hmm. sequel to New Leaf maybe coming out. And the reason I say it's rumored, Jason Greer, it's speculation, is because they said that the Animal Crossing mobile game is going to have some sort of interaction with a home platform game. So,
question.
Yeah.
About the general time range of E3. Do you think that we're going to get any news about another round of Nintendo World Championships?
I doubt it.
Really?
No, I don't think it's going to happen this year.
So do you think that this is just a decision that kind of is set alone, it wasn't influenced by anything, or do you think that it was influenced by how well or not well it did last year?
Well, we were there last year.
And it seemed like it was very well received.
I was in, like, the fifth row.
Yeah.
And I had a blast. But the theater was not full. It was not full. It was still a really cool event. But if you look back, if we go back to a year ago when they announced, Nintendo announced their E3 plans.
Yeah.
It was this video that Reggie was there and Mega 64 was doing like this whole like Reggie. Was that the Mega 64 one where they did the Reggie bot? I can't remember. But they had this whole like video event.
Yeah.
And this year all we got was a press release.
Yeah.
And it broke my heart. So Nintendo's obviously not taking E3 seriously this year, or they just don't have a lot to show off. So
Yeah, they could actually mask that if they wanted to. I feel like they could. I mean, just release small bits of information, and have something more than just one experience at E3. I feel like there is still a way to go about presentation and making it feel more elaborate and worthwhile for fans and media without actually having to put forth great effort.
Yeah.
There really is.
Well, we'll see. We'll see what happens here. I'm excited to see what they're going to do with Zelda U.
Yeah.
I'll point this last thing out before we move on to the next topic. And the next topic, by the way, is the speed round, but which is so speedy.
So speedy.
So the idea that I know that it's going to be a simultaneous release with the NX and the Wii U version, getting such like an immersive experience with the Wii U version, I, in the back of my head the entire time, I'm going to know there's a better version out there somewhere.
Yeah.
And I'm going to like, oh, this is great. But I wonder what the version I'm actually going to buy is going to look like. Because I'm obviously buying the NX version because I'm buying an NX the day it comes out. So they can immerse me all day long with whatever they want to immerse me with. But at the same time, too, it's just going to be like, well, how's the NX version going to handle this?
So what you're saying is it's basically going to be like you're testing out the second best.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like you're giving me an entire event to this second best thing.
Yeah.
So I would, Nintendo, I would just beg you at E3 this year to just show off some NX footage for the game.
Yeah.
Get people excited. Get people ready for this piece of hardware that you have coming in March of 2017.
That's fair.
So
that's a fair request.
And that's all I ask. That's it.
That's it. That's it.
And send me stuff.
Amiibo Jason.
And send me a dev kit. That's all I need. That's it. I want to make my own games.
Okay, moving on.
All right, folks. It's everybody's favorite segment. The world famous Nintendo News Speed Round.
Which is not even a speed round.
Okay, is it this Nintendo... I never really thought of this. Is it the Nintendo Inquirer Speed Round? Because it used to be called the Amiibo News Speed Round. So is it the Nintendo News Speed Round? Let's just call it the Speed Round.
Sure.
All right.
I'm not going to be picky.
Welcome to the speed round.
Dun, 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 dun.
Where none of the questions are answered speedily. Speedily.
Speedily.
Speedful.
Fast.
Fast.
We've gone through the synonyms and whatnot.
We post questions on Twitter today asking you, the Nintendo Newscast listener, what you wanted us, Happily Candied and Amiibo Jason, to answer for you. So let's go down the list and pick out the ones that aren't full of racism and bigotry.
And who would ever?
Oh, the internet does. And the internet will. So, first and foremost, we have Michael. What game are you most excited for and why? Zelda U, for all the reasons I already mentioned before. It's going to be great.
Yep.
Lauren.
I have two games, and it's going to be Zelda, just because I am so excited for this immersive experience. And I am so ready for Kirby Planet Robobot. I'm a huge Kirby fan, and I love Triple Deluxe. I cannot wait to get my hands on Robobot.
There you go. All right, want to do this next one?
Sure. This is from Megalo24.
Yeah.
And this person is asking, do you think there'll be different colors for Amiibo?
Yes, they already did it. The Splatoon Amiibo.
And other variants like the Mario Amiibo.
Yes. So they've already done it. I think he's asking, are we going to see different colors in the Smash line?
Oh.
I have a theory. I have a feeling we're going to see possibly a male Wii Fit trainer. I have a feeling we are going to see possible Fire Emblem gender reversals.
Yep.
So, possibly.
That's my thought. I want a rose gold peach.
I bet you do.
That's it.
Peach is the best.
The best.
All right. We have Jennifer, artistic doodle. Love you, by the way.
That's cute.
What side would you fight for in the upcoming Splatfest? Fancy party versus costume party? So, the new Splatfest, if you're not familiar with this yet, is Miitomo-based, which is really cool. I would probably go the costume party because I do not take myself seriously.
And
I do and I don't.
I would go for the fancy party, obviously. Wouldn't you say fancy party for me?
Sure. We'll say that. I don't know.
So unenthusiastic. You're so unenthusiastic sometimes.
I don't know if you guys noticed Happily Candied's hair is Fire Engine Red. Do they allow Fire Engine Red hair at fancy parties?
I can be fancy and have red hair.
Okay. I was unaware. I didn't know.
And that's a quote by Happily Candied.
There you go. All right, next we have CJ. Is Reggie's body ready?
His body is so ready for this immersive Zelda experience.
Reggie's body is incapable of not being ready.
Yes.
It's a condition he had when he was a small child.
He was
always ready.
I was going to say he was born ready.
Born ready.
Reggie was born ready.
And due to a chemical imbalance, he's always in the ready position. There you go. Yes, he's ready.
Yes.
Do you want to read this one?
Can you?
Yeah, do you want me to hover it?
This please, one, this one, please, this one. Thank you. Let's see. This is from Guillermo Gomez Jr., also known as Guillermo, Dead Stormed. This person says, any expectations for the new Pokemon games?
I will tell you on May 10th.
Good to go. We're good on that one. Okay.
There we go. Next one, we have ADVE3. ADV3?
Yes.
ADV3.
Yes,
what are your CP. What are your speculation for the speculated Pokemon amiibo? I love how you speculate twice. You must be a Jason Greer fan.
Oh, that's so funny.
Jason yes! Greer, what are you doing?
Please love this. Is he freaking out, Mind Freak right now?
I hope so.
Yeah.
Yes, I think it's going to happen. I think we're going to have some sort of information about that. I don't think it's going to happen on the 10th when we get some of the information.
Yeah.
Nintendo would be insane if they didn't partner with Game Freak on a Pokemon amiibo line for Sun and Moon.
Yes.
And they definitely need the money this year. So that's
okay. I love the little laugh.
They need it.
Okay. That's good enough for that answer.
They need to push the amiibo button. The we are desperate for money button.
Yes.
Like if they announce a Pokemon MMO,
yeah.
Even though technically what is that Pokemon Go is yes. sort of like that, you know they're desperate.
Yeah.
Like that's the last straw.
Yeah.
So we have Javier. How do you feel about the NX rumors about the console running cartridges again? I think it's amazing.
Amazing. Now, is that just for the nostalgia trip or is that for actual convenience and...
Speed.
Speed. Ah, there we go.
Oh my God. Loading is hell
on
a lot of games on the PS4 and the Xbox One.
Yeah.
It's ridiculous.
Yeah.
I'll give you an example.
Please.
It is Just Cause 3. Just Cause 3, from what I saw, took like 10 minutes to load on the Xbox One.
Pass.
Which is ridiculous.
I really don't have a lot of experience with other consoles outside of Nintendo, yeah. so I don't have a lot to compare it to.
But you have, at this point, you have better forms of media that can read and write faster.
Mm-hmm.
You have flash memory on like micro SD cards now that can surpass 256 gigabytes of information, which is insane. It's insanely fast. And the memory card in our new camera, it can read and write 4K. It's a super high speed device at 128 gigabytes. You can get that for $50. So you work with a chip manufacturer that can get something that can read and write very quickly.
Yeah.
And you can eliminate a lot of that craziness from loading. Oh my God. I am ecstatic for that.
Awesome.
But I honestly don't think it's going to be like a big fat cartridge.
Yeah.
I think it's going to be something pretty tiny. I'm not thinking like micro SD small.
No.
Because these aren't just like flash media.
Yeah.
This is like actual physical chips.
Yeah.
I'm expecting for it to be wildly popular once people realize what it can do.
Well, other than the practical use, for me it was a nostalgia trip. Well, I honestly miss cartridges. I was never a fan of the disc or anything.
Well, Javier, you got me on a tangent here.
Okay.
No, I got to talk. I got
to
say.
Jason,
I have to say one mention
Jason
here.
Gave me a talk before this, and he's like, Lauren, we have to make this speedy. We're going to make this round speedy. And I actually have been, and you have strayed.
Well, I broke the rules. So here's the reason why I think some people are skeptical about the cartridge.
Yes.
N64 versus PS1. The PlayStation 1 was obviously wildly more successful.
Yeah.
As far as, from a sales perspective. And one of the reasons why you didn't see games like Final Fantasy VII on the Nintendo 64 was because it didn't have the capability to handle full motion video on its cartridge. We are way beyond that, folks. You can put a lot more on a piece of flash media and a lot more onto a chip than you can on a 50 gigabyte Blu-ray disc at this point. So, yes, it's a great idea. Please happen. Thank you for the question, by the way. Do you want to do Austin's?
Sure.
This one.
Let's see. Austin asks, what game do you want to throw in the trash where it belongs? Oh, that's not very nice. I don't want to read the next part.
Austin.
It says hint. It starts with star and ends with Fox Zero. Austin, come
on. Star Fox Zero is a great game. People, I think, and this is the honest to God truth about Star Fox Zero. I loved it. It took me some time to figure out the controls and to get accustomed to it. But once I did, it was a blast. Mm-hmm. And I think a lot of people let the gaming media sway them.
Completely.
Especially the gaming media that didn't even play the dang game.
Yeah.
All the way through.
Yeah.
So that being said, pick up the game.
Make up your minds for yourselves.
Yeah.
And give it a chance. You know, when the Wii first came out, you first had the Wii remote.
Yeah.
It's something completely new, completely innovative. I did not like the idea at first.
Yeah.
It took me a while to get used to it, but I gave it a chance and I warmed up to it. The same thing goes, and I'm not saying that, oh, you'll just be, you know, content with Star Fox.
Yeah.
I'm saying Jason really enjoyed himself after he gave a chance.
Ooh, that could be...
Jason really enjoyed his experience with Star Fox Zero. Is that better for you? Okay, good. Okay, good.
What she said first.
I have to watch what I say with Jason.
It's a good game.
Yes.
But games that should be thrown in the garbage, Skylanders Superchargers.
Okay, moving on.
Moving on. All right.
Okay, one more question. One more.
All right, let's take this next one here from Davis. So Davis.
Davis Hunzinger.
Hunzinger.
We are very familiar with you. Thank you for always joining our live streams.
He asks, Mario Party 10 Amiibo line? Continuation? Question mark?
Hmm.
No. It's not going to happen.
It was not well received.
So here's my thought on why.
Sure.
Mario Party 10 was an epic failure. Nobody liked it.
I actually enjoyed it.
It was a backpedal in the Mario Party franchise.
I liked it.
The Bowser mode was fun.
Mm-hmm.
But the minigames sucked. They were lackluster. You have a Wii U gamepad. You could have come up with better freaking minigames. And they took a step backwards, and they had this absolutely terrible board game mode.
Yeah.
So if Mario Party 10 was popular,
yeah,
and people bought it in droves, yes, I think they would continue it.
Mm-hmm.
Will they continue? I think the better question here is, will they continue the Super Mario Brothers line in any way?
Yes.
I think we will. We have not seen Rosalina restocked in a long time. It's very difficult to find.
Do you think they're going to re-release that new Rosalina that people are speculating about? Maybe not for the Mario Party 10 series, yeah, but in another form.
I think we're going to see that. I
yes.
think we're going to see a new. I think we're going to see a new game that Rosalina is going to be in.
Okay.
I also think the same thing about Kid Icarus, and I wanted to say this for a bit. I honestly, wholeheartedly believe by the end of this year, we're going to have a new Kid Icarus game on either 3DS or Wii U. And one of the reasons why is because we have two characters in Kid Icarus that have not received any kind of substantial restock, and that's Politana and that's Pit. We have Dark Pit, but those two are just impossible to find still.
Yeah.
Which is bizarre to me. And especially when pretty much everything else besides like Lucina and Robin have been restocked plentifully. So I'm thinking we're going to see some sort of game with Rosalina and the Mario Brothers at some point
Super
this year.
So Super Mario Galaxy?
Maybe for the NX.
Okay.
I don't think they would pull the trigger on that for the Wii U.
Okay.
I could totally see that being a launch title on the NX. Maybe something more of like a casual sports title.
Oh.
And
I'm not as into that. Sorry. Careful there.
Oh, yeah. I like to shake.
Yeah.
And it's still a possibility that we might see some sort of amiibo announced for the Rio games coming out on the Wii U, but
yeah,
we're running really low on time for that one. So, crossing my fingers. But yeah, I mean, Nintendo's not going to let a character like Rosalina.
Why the accent?
It was Cinco de Mayo 2 days ago. And I'm Hispanic.
How Hispanic are you?
I'm a quarter.
I know that already.
I'm one quarter.
Celebrate!
Hooray. but yeah, they're not going to let a character like Rosalina not get another amiibo. So yes, I think it's going to happen.
Good answer.
Anything from you?
Nope.
There we go.
I'm tired.
There you go, folks. That's another episode of the Nintendo Newscast in the can. My name's Amiibo Jason. You can find me on my personal Twitter account, at Amiibo Jason. You can also find me at Amiibo News, where you can get everything and anything amiibo related there. And our website, NintendoEnquirer.com. What about you? Where can we find you?
You can find me at Happily Candied on Twitter. My personal website with photos of really cute things, lots of sweet things, also known as my sugary corner of the world, HappilyCandied.com, is linked in the Twitter description on my page.
That's amazing.
Thank you. And don't forget that Nintendo Inquirer is also on Twitter, and you can find that at NintendoINQ.
And I just want to point this out real quick, because you're going to see this on Sunday. We are going to be venturing into the fantastic world of Patreon. So you can check out that on our website. We're going to have some information up on our Twitter page soon. But for you listening or watching this, you're going to have the first kind of announcement that we're going to be moving into the Patreon realm. We have some really, really cool perks, some physical merchandise. It's going to be really neat. We're going to try to do this in a way that's going to make it beneficial for not just us, but for you. So keep an eye out there.
Yep.
All right. Have a good morning, or a good evening, or a good afternoon, depending on when you're listening or watching this. And we'll see you next week.
Bye, guys.
Goodbye.